other this country, apart from a tour of American bases here. Which is odd when you remember that many of his records, like Hello Mary Lou and It's Late, were big hits over here about 10 years ago. Rick, what was the American view of the British scene in the pre-Beatles days?
Well, I can remember over there, you know, like during the 50s, actually, you know, England was thought of as almost like, you know, Holland and all that. It wasn't really that important until the Beatles came along and really upgraded music, I feel.
Yeah. Did you ever worry in those days about selling or not selling records here?
I didn't think about it that much. You know, I was so involved, like, over in the States and things, and making appearances over there. And, you know, at that time, really, you know, it was the very beginnings of rock and roll, really, when I started. And it really wasn't that important at that time, it didn't seem like, over there, you know.
And when the Beatles and all the other bands came along, that kind of put an end to the first phase of your career.
Well, it really did. It put an end to a lot of Americans' careers, really. And it was a kind of a time for me to sort of take an objective look at myself, really, and see whether I really what I wanted to do. I wasn't very happy with what I was doing at that time, and I didn't seem to have much of a direction. Mm. But it gave me the opportunity to kind of step back and take a look at things and hopefully, you know, work them out, really.
And it's funny thinking back to that British invasion thing. If you played your old records and the Beatles' first records side by side, then there's really not much difference in retrospect, is there? I mean, yours are no worse, you know, maybe no better, but certainly no worse.
Well, only that it was a better version, really, of course, you know, a much better version.
Think so?
I think so. Yeah. I really do, you know, sound-wise. And by that time, I think the recording techniques had improved so much, and also, you know, they had such a very distinct sound and such a good sound, really, that I know that was the main reason it caught on. And by that time, everything had gotten so involved, you know, musically, over in America. Nobody knew what they wanted to do, you know, what the next step was. So it was just perfect to sort of they cleaned all that out and went back to the very roots of rock and roll, really.
Yeah, what did you try and do then when your records stopped being hits?
I laid around a lot, you know, in the sun, and I thought about what I wanted to do, and I had been playing like nightclubs that I wasn't very happy with, you know, and doing nothing but old songs of mine.
Did you ever get into singing ballads and standards and things like that?
Yeah, I did, as a matter of fact. I had a couple songs that, like For You and Fools Rush In and songs like that that I did during that time, which were fairly successful for me over there. But I just really wasn't happy with what I was doing, you know?
Mm. And what made you want to come back?
Well, you never look at yourself like really as coming back, you know? But I guess that's what it is, you know? It's sort of like a thing where I found the thing that I wanted to do, and I really made what I feel is a total commitment to music. And I got involved in trying to write songs and everything, and really trying to play the guitar, not just play 3 1/2 chords, you know. And right now I've been fortunate enough to find a band that I'm really happy with, and that's what I did really at the beginning. I sort of handpicked the band at the very beginning, you know, and that's what I did now, you know. And it's kind of, it set me off, I think, in the right direction. At least it is for me. It's a very good feeling for me.
And what musical direction is the band going in?
Well, just to play good, natural music, you know, and everybody has the freedom to play whatever they want, you know. It's not like they're tied into one specific thing for a specific song, you know. So we're constantly experimenting with different sounds and playing songs differently all the time. So it's a very nice, free, good feeling, and everybody is really together on this, and it's a very rewarding thing, I think.
Yeah. Rick, thanks a lot, and we'll look forward to seeing you play in Britain over the next couple of weeks. And when he's strapped on his guitar, he's going to sing a track from the new album, Rudy the Fifth. This is a Dylan song, Love Minus Zero, No Limit.
My love, she speaks like silence, without ideals of violence. She doesn't have to say she's faithful, yet she's true like ice, like fire. Promises by the hours. My love, she lasts the most. Valentine's can't buy her. Dime stores and bus stations, people talk of situations, read books, repeat quotations, draw conclusions on the wall. By the hour, there's no success like failure, and that failure's no success at all. Cold.